Hello friends, welcome to today's session. So today we'll discuss about AWS services. Okay, what are the services provided by Amazon Cloud? So we'll discuss, we'll just walk through all the services. So if you can see that there is compute service, developer tool, mobile services, internet of things, storage service, management tools, and application service, contact center, database service, security identity and compliance, messaging service, the end development, migration, analytics, business productivity, network and content delivery, artificial intelligence, desktop and upstream. So these are the services provided by the Amazon Cloud. So we'll just walk through all the services. Okay. So let's start. I have already logged into AWS Management Console. You can see, so these are the services provided by Amazon Cloud. Okay, so we'll discuss, okay, we'll just walk through all the services. Okay, there is so many services provided by Amazon Cloud. So we'll walk through one by one. So if you under compute, there is a service called EC2. Okay. So EC2 stands for Elastic Compute Cloud. It is a web service that provides secure, resizable compute capacity in the cloud. It is designed to make web-scale computer easier for developers. That means EC2 stands for Elastic Compute Cloud. So it is, so if you want to, it is a popular service only. So if you want to create an instance or virtual servers, so through which you can launch your instance or virtual servers as per your requirement. Okay, this is EC2 service. Then Lightcell. So Lightcell, Amazon Lightcell, is a design to be easiest way to launch and manage a virtual private server with AWS. Okay, the Lightcell plans include everything you need to jumpstart your project: a virtual machine, SSD based storage, data transfer, DNS management, and static IP address for a low and predictable price. Okay. So there is the Lightcell service. The third service is Elastic Container Service. Elastic Container Service. That means it is it is a highly scalable, highly performance. It is a container management service that supports Docker containers. That means if you want to run any Docker container, so we'll discuss the Docker part. Okay, so which is part of DevOps. So we'll discuss the Docker, how to create a Docker container, all those things later. So if you want to run any Docker container, okay, so you can run your Docker container under Elastic Container Service. So it is Elastic Container Service provided by AWS to run the Docker container. So it will provide highly scalable, high performance and high availability also. Okay, it allows you to easily run application on a managed cluster of Amazon EC2 instances. So it will form a clusters, so there will be no downtime. Okay. Then fourth service is Lambda. So AWS Lambda lets you run code without provisioning or managing servers. Okay, you pay only for the compute time you consume. Okay, there is no charge when your code is not running. That means, okay, there is no need to maintain any servers. Okay, only you need to upload your code. Okay, then Lambda will take care. Okay, then fourth service is batch service. Okay, AWS batch. So AWS batch enables developers or engineers to easily and efficiently run hundreds of thousands of batch computing job on AWS. So if the requirement is to run any jobs, hundreds of thousands of jobs, then the AWS batch will help on that. Okay, so it is the batch computing batch processing service. Okay, then last service is under compute, Elastic Beanstalk. Okay, Elastic Beanstalk is an easy to use service for deploying web application and service developed with Java, .NET, PHP, Node.js, Python, Ruby. Okay, so you can launch your web application you can launch your web application, which is developed in Java, .NET, PHP, or any type of on Ruby. Okay, so you can you can deploy your code. So Elastic Beanstalk will will take care about the operating systems and availability, performance, all those things, and also later also you can customize also your settings also. Okay, so this much for under computing we discussed we just walked through the six services under compute. Okay, then we will discussion then we will go to storage part. So first we will discuss the S3. So S3 stands for simple storage service. Okay, Amazon simple storage service is object storage with simple web service interface to store and read write any amount of data from anywhere on the web. So it is a storage service, so you can upload or download any amount of data in the so it will provide a web service interface, so through which you can upload or download. Okay, so for the S3 lab practical I have already uploaded video for S3, so you can learn how to upload data and how to create bucket. All those things I have already discussed on S3 part. Okay, then EFS. So the second service is EFS. So EFS stands for Elastic File System. Amazon Elastic File System provides simple scalable file storage for use with Amazon EC2 instance in the AWS cloud. Okay, so EFS, so here in EFS is a storage service, one of the most popular if you know the Linux, then kind of NFS. Okay, NFS. So here you need to create a you need to create a EFS share, you need to create a share. Okay, then you need to export that share to a availability zone. Okay, so in that availability zone, whatever instance or virtual source we have created, they are able to access that share also. You can mount that share. So same share can be mounted mounted so several instances. Okay, then Glacier. Okay, so Amazon Glacier is the storage service, so which is used to store the archival archival data. That means, so in so it is basically which data is not required for frequently access, infrequent data. Suppose some data requires only yearly once only, so we can store the data in the Glacier. Okay, in the Glacier, so infrequent data can be stored on Glacier. Okay, so it is a low cost storage as compared to S3. So Glacier is low cost only, so you can store the archival data in Glacier. Okay, then the storage gateway. Storage gateway, which will help you to suppose I have one data center, on premises data center, so I want to use the storage service from the cloud. So storage gateway will provide you it will create a connection from your on premises data center to the AWS cloud. Okay, for the storage service, so AWS storage service seamlessly enable hybrid storage between on premises storage environment and the AWS cloud. Okay, so we discussed about the all the storage service provided by the AWS. So now we'll discuss database part. What are the database service provided by the Amazon cloud? So first service is RDS. So RDS stands for Relational Database System. So it makes easy to set up and operate and scale and relational database in the cloud. Okay, so RDS, under RDS support PostgreSQL, MySQL, Oracle, okay, Microsoft SQL Server. So these are the common under the RDS service. Okay, then DynamoDB. So Amazon DynamoDB is a fast and flexible new SQL database service for all applications that need consistent single digit millisecond latency at any scale. It is a fully managed database and support both document and key value data model. Okay, so it's the main benefit is fast and consistent performance. Performance is very high, highly scalable, fully managed, and the flexible, fine-grained access control. So these are the benefits of DynamoDB. Then we'll go for the Elastic Cache. Amazon Elastic Cache is a web service. It's a web service that makes it easy to deploy, operate, and scale an in-memory cache in the cloud. The service improves the performance of web application by allowing you to retrieve information from fast managing memory caches instead of relying entirely on slower disk-based database. So that means, it is a memory, in-memory database basically. Amazon Elastic is a memory database. Okay, so the performance will be very high because the data will be retrieved from the memory itself. Okay, so it will be a data transfer speed will be high. Then the Amazon Redshift, so it is also one database service. So guys, we will discuss on a migration part now. Okay, so migration part, so migrate means if you want to migrate from data from your AWS for your on-premises data center to the cloud, so these are the migration service. Okay, so first AWS migration, second is application discovery service. What is application discovery service? So application discovery help to system integrator quickly and reliably plan application migration project by automatically identify application running in on-premises data center, their associated dependency and their performance profile. Okay, so this is the application discovery service, here the application migration. Then it will be the database migration service. So it is a, if you want to migrate your data database from on-premises data center to a cloud, so it is a, it will help you to migrate your database. Then server migration service, so that means if you want to migrate on-premises server to a cloud, so it will help the server migration, it will help you, server migration service. Then Snowball, it is also a service. So if you want to transfer your petabyte of data from your on-premises data center to the cloud, so it will provide a it will help you, the Snowball service. Okay, so we'll discuss on how we can enable the service, how we'll avail the service. So these are the things we'll discuss on Snowball. But now we'll discuss on network and content delivery service. So these are five services provided the network. It is coming under network and content delivery. First is VPC. VPC stands for virtual private cloud. So that means it will provide you. And so VPC lets you provision a logical isolated section of the AWS cloud where you can launch AWS resources in a virtual network that you define. Through VPC, you will create your own network, okay, and you can launch your servers, instances, and whatever resources available, you can launch your resources inside that virtual network. Okay. So you can create your customers, routing table. You can create your own, own gateway. Which will restrict. Suppose I want that database service should not be reached to the internet database, my database servers. So I will restrict in that way also using the VPC. So that means VP is a virtual network. Okay, it is a virtual network. So inside the virtual network, you will launch your resources. Okay, it is isolated from the other networks, from the public networks. Okay, then the second service is CloudFront. Okay, CloudFront, Amazon CloudFront is a global content delivery network service that SLA delivery of your websites, API, video content, or other web assets. It integrates with other AWS products to give developer and businesses an easy way to isolate content to end user with no minimum user commitment. That means CloudFront is a service. Basically, it is a content delivery network. That means suppose my data centers, I am my data is available on Mumbai data centers. Okay, that means I am in Asia Pacific region and I am using the, I have created all my instances, all the data is available in my mind. So if any user, you know, if any user trying to access my data from US East region or from the US East region, then it will take time, right? So if I enable the cloud front, okay, that means it will create a edge location in the US East region. Okay, when it will, when the user from the US East region trying to access the data, then from the edge location it will it will provide the data to the user. So data transfer data retrieval speed will be faster. Okay, that is the cloud front. Then the Route 53. So Route 53 is a highly available and scalable cloud domain naming system web service. It designed to give developer and businesses an extremely reliable and cost effective way to route a user to internet application by translating human readable names such as www.example.com. That means Route 53 is a DNS service. You can register your domain, or you can migrate your existing domain to the Route 53. So it is a DNS service provided by the AWS. Then API gateway, then the direct connect. So direct connect makes easy to establish a dedicated network connection from your premises to AWS. So if you want to put a dedicated connection from your, suppose some resources is running on my AWS cloud. So what I will do, I will put a, I will create a, I will establish a direct connection from your on-premises data center to the AWS cloud. Okay, so that is the called direct connect. Now we'll discuss some developer tools. So developer tool first services provide the code star, then the code commit, code build, code deploy, code pipeline, cloud 9 and etc. So code commit, what is code commit? So code commit is a fully managed source control service that makes easy to for companies to host secure and highly scalable private Git repository. That means a developer is developing a code, right? So the developer needs to put some code in the repository. So it is a kind of versioning control system. It is kind of like Git. Okay, like Git, it is a code commit. Okay, like Git. So it is like Git is a versioning control system, right? So code commit is will provide the same service. There is no need to build any servers. Okay, the in-house or something. There is no need to. So only use developer only develop the code and he needs to it is a repository only. Okay, then code build. Code build is a fully managed build service that compiles source code, run test and produces. That means code build is like it is a build tool, like if you see that in a Maven, and these are the build, right? So AWS also providing the code build. Code build means the developer write the code, then it uploaded in the repository, then the code build will help you to build the code for deployment. Okay, then code deploy. After building, need to deploy the code in the application and need to deploy the code. Okay, so like deploy, like that for the deployment service, like Jenkins, right? It's a continuous integration, continuous delivery service, right? So for deployment, it will help you to deploy your, so we the code has been built, now it is the time to deploy the code. Okay, then code pipeline. Okay, code pipeline is like Jenkins. Okay, system continuous integration, continuous CI/CD, continuous integration, continuous delivery service. Okay, then the X-ray service. So AWS X-ray helps developer analyze and debug distributed application production or under development, such as those build using. So now we'll discuss on management tool like CloudWatch. CloudWatch is a monitoring tool only. So it is a tool which is which will use to monitor your resources, monitor your servers, all those things. Okay, so there is no need to go for the third party. Okay, So AWS auto scaling. So AWS auto scaling means, so it will scale up or scale down your instances as per the condition. Suppose my instance count will increase to 2 when the memory utilization CPU utilization reaches to cross 60%. So and when the my instance count will come to 1 when the memory utilization or CPU utilization reaches to 30%. So it is it would do automatically scale up and scale out. Then cloud formation. Then cloud formation gives developer and system administrator an easy to create and manage a collection related AWS resources, provisioning and updating them in an orderly and predictable fashion. Okay, so you can use the AWS CloudFormation sample template or create your own template to describe your AWS resource and any associated dependency or runtime parameter. Okay, required to run your application. Okay, then this is called CloudFormation. Then we will go to the CloudTrail. CloudTrail is a web service that record AWS API call for your account and deliver log file to you. Okay, so that means AWS CloudTrail, what are the API call is happening to the AWS resources, so it will capture all the logs. So basically it will help you for the auditing purpose. Okay, then AWS config. So AWS config is a fully managed service that provides you with an AWS resource inventory, configuration history and configuration change notification to enable security and governance. Okay, then the OpsWork. AWS OpsWork is a configuration management service that uses Chef, an automation platform that treats servicer configuration as code. OpsWork uses Chef to automate how servers and configure, deploy and manage across your EC2 instances or on-premises compute environment. Okay, then service catalog. AWS service catalog allow organization to create manage catalog of IT services that are approved for use in AWS. Okay, then the AWS system manager. System manager, if you want to run any kind of system manager will help you. If you want to run any command, then the system manager will help you to run command on the on-premises servers. Okay, then trusted advisor. Trusted advisor is an online resource to help you reduce cost, increase performance and improve the security by optimizing your AWS environment. Okay, trusted advisor provides real-time guidance to help you provision your resource following AWS best practices. Okay, so these are the services provided under. Now we'll discuss the security identity and compliance. So under IAM stands for identity access management. So it will provide the user so it will help you to do user management, group management, permissions related stuff to the AWS cloud. Okay, these are sort of monitors for secret manager, guard duty, inspector. So inspector is nothing but, inspector is an automated security assessment service that help improve the security and compliance of application deployed on AWS. Amazon inspector automatically assess application for vulnerability or deviation from best practice. Any vulnerability happens in your with your resources, then it will notify you. Okay, it will notify you. Then certificate manager. Certificate manager is a service that you easily provision, manage and deploy secure socket layer or transport a SSL and TLS certificate for use with AWS services. Okay, that is certificate service. Okay, certificate managers. Okay, which you provide the certificates which help you to deploy certificates in your environment. Okay, then cloud SSL. So guys, so we discussed the compute part, storage part, then database, developer tool, management tool, then the IAM part also. Okay, so whatever things is required for the sysops admin, okay, for the AWS admin, so we discussed all those things. Okay, So rest of the things is no needed for a CSOP guys. So hope you enjoy the tutorial, and this is the just walkthrough, okay? And we'll discuss in details later, okay? And I have already uploaded some videos, okay, in details for some of the services, okay? So you can go through that, okay? So if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, and for the latest